The fourth condition is love, al-mahabbah. Al-mahabbah is to love la ilaha illallah. The opposite of al-mahabbah is hatred, and we should not have even a bit of hate for Kalima Tawheed. We must have love for Kalima Tawheed, for its meaning, and all those people who know and practice its correct teaching. And the evidence, or dalil, for love is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. And the meaning of this ayah is, and among the people are those who take other than Allah as equals to Him. They love them as they should love Allah, but those who believe are stronger in love for Allah. But is every form of love truthful? That is why the fifth condition is truthfulness, as-sidq. As-sidq is to truthfully affirm that la ilaha illallah. The opposite of as-sidq is hypocrisy. Love can be deceitful or hypocritical as well. The evidence for this is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And of mankind, there are some who say, we believe in Allah and the last day, while in fact they believe not. Now we come to the sixth condition. The sixth condition is acceptance, al-qubul. Al-qubul is to accept la ilaha illallah. The opposite of al-qubul is rejection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Truly, when it is said to them, لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, they puffed themselves up with pride. The disbelievers did not say Kalima Tawheed with their tongues. They did not believe in it, and they used to reject it. It is important to accept and affirm La ilaha illallah by uttering it with the tongue. Now we come to the seventh condition. The seventh and last condition is submission, al-inqiyad. Al-inqiyad is to implement along with its necessities in actions, La ilaha illallah. The opposite of al-inqiyad is abandonment. If we accept it and utter it with our tongues, but do not act upon it, then what is the benefit of accepting it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجْهَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ فَقَدِ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى وَإِلَى اللَّهِ عَاكِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And whoever submits his face to Allah while he is a doer of good, then he has grasped the most trustworthy handhold, and to Allah will be the outcome of all matters. So you can see here that it is about submitting our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is called al-inqiyad, submitting oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and putting Kalima Tawheed and its necessities into practice through actions. Remember that we come to know from the above conditions that Kalima Tawheed is not about articulation of the tongue alone. Rather, along with pronouncing it verbally, one needs to have knowledge, certainty, sincerity, love, truthfulness, acceptance, and implementation of it through actions. Thank you for watching here for the hereafter.